Luke, Eric, Lady A, Miranda, Jason, Dirks. What are they all up to? It's the Nashville Nibble, your country music inside news source. Here's Ryan Keith with your top five news stories.
And here we go. Number five, before he was a country star, Louisiana native Hunter Hayes showed up as a little kid playing an accordion on Maury on one of his Most Talented Kid episodes. And Maury Povich talked about it to People magazine.
Hunter, aren't you a little too young to be dumping anybody? At
I
your
just,
age?
I just didn't want to get more than that because I was restless having those girls on my mind and I was like, oh no.
First of all, he played the accordion on my show. I mean, right. Now he's become this, you know, I think it was his precociousness. He was just terrific. I mean, this small little kid, he had a great vocabulary, very articulate, and a great smile.
Number four, Jason Aldean is now an author. That's right, he has a book out. It's called Family, Friends, and Fans. And it's described as a musician's diary with stories that influence his life from his early years in Georgia, becoming a star, his family, his band, and his wife, Brittany. He wrote it with a professional writer who co-wrote the book, so it's one of those deals. Again, Jason Aldean's new book is called Family, Friends, and Fans. Number three, Kane Brown has a hit on his hands, and he talked about writing What Ifs, his duet with Lauren Elena.
We didn't really know what we were going to write that day, and we just came up with what ifs, asking about, you know, in a relationship, there's always these questions asking, you know, what if this, what if that, and we decided to make it into a song. It felt like a really good duet opportunity, and I've always wanted my friend Lauren Elena on it because we went to school together and we were in choir together, and she's the one that convinced me into singing, and she's really what motivated me to sing coming in second on American Idol, and it's my most asked about song on the album.
Number two, this is kind of funny. A scammer posing as Kix Brooks is messaging people on Facebook, and yesterday he hit up Barbara Brooks, the wife of Kix Brooks. So she posted a message on Twitter with the caption, "The irony of one of Kix Brooks' hackers sending me a message is pretty hilarious." And the number one story coming out of Nashville, Dolly Parton was recently asked how it feels to touch so many people's lives with her music.
Yeah, sometimes I do pull on that to think, well, you know, it's like, well, it makes sense if I can have touched that many people in that way, you know, at my age when you don't even know what you're going to do, you're just hoping to make it and you have your dreams and hope they come true. And then when you get older, you hope you can look back and say somebody's got something nice to say about you. But yeah, I do draw from that. It's an inspiration. I'm touched and moved and humbled by it.
That is your top five stories coming out of Nashville. This is the Nashville Nibble on Gator 99.5.